RFC 2544 defines a set of tests to benchmark network performance. VIAVI has enhanced the methodology into an ideal workflow for Metro Ethernet service acceptance. The workflow is a standard feature for all Ethernet options on OneAdvisor 800 platforms. All modules with optical hardware can be licensed for 10 megabit to 25 gigabit Ethernet testing using SFP ports, and 100 gigabit testing using QSFP ports. 400G modules can also be optioned for 50, 200, and 400 gigabit testing. I will demonstrate a Layer 2 RFC 2544 test with a 1 gig E optical transceiver in port 1 of my OneAdvisor. The transceiver is connected to an Ethernet switch, which is connected to a second switch with a VIAVI loopback device on one of its ports. The loopback device is another OneAdvisor, but it could be a VIAVI T-Bird 5800, NSC200 network and service companion, JMEP loopable SFP, or another compatible loopback. The user interface is the same at all rates. The workflow will prompt you to configure the test, loop up the far end device, start traffic, measure key performance indicators, and save a pass-fail report. The workflow can also be run at Layer 3 with IPv4 or IPv6 addressing. One additional configuration screen allows IP addressing to be configured. I will now demonstrate the test application. I have powered up my OneAdvisor. From the home screen, I will tap Tests to display the test menu. Tap Transport to show the transport test application, and tap the transport icon. I can now launch the test with a single tap on my pre-configured favorite test list or from the Select Test menu. I'll use the Select Test menu and select the Ethernet, 1 gig optical, RFC 2544 Layer 2 traffic test on port 1. I now have options to edit my previous configuration, load a configuration from a previously saved profile, or start a new configuration with default settings. I will go with the third option. The default settings can be viewed and customized in a series of configuration screens connected by Next and Back buttons. Although there are several screens, most settings can be left at defaults. The first screen shows symmetry settings for the test. The OneAdvisor RFC 2544 workflow supports symmetric links terminated at a loopback device. This next screen shows local port settings. The link is active and I am configured to auto-negotiate pause capabilities. I recommend leaving frame type and test mode at defaults for most use cases. Encapsulation can be changed to VLAN, QNQ, or stacked VLAN if tagging is required. The light blue link will display advanced settings. If you're using a non-VIAVI loopback device, these settings allow you to specify the MAC address of the soft loopback. If you're using a VIAVI loopback device and the default setting, the OneAdvisor will broadcast a loop-up message and learn the MAC address. The next screen allows you to apply a template containing pass-fail criteria proposed by the Metro Ethernet Forum for a variety of network types. I will opt not to use a configuration template. I can now select which tests I want to run: throughput, latency, frame loss, and packet jitter are the most common tests. If committed burst size is specified in your service level agreement, you can also select burst test. Back-to-back and system recovery are not typically used for service acceptance tests. Extended load can be selected to extend the test time up to 24 hours. The committed information rate should be entered in the max bandwidth field. I'll leave this setting at the default to test at line rate. L1 Mbps means that load-related settings will include layer 1 overhead. When set to line rate, the ONA will still leave a small amount of bandwidth so that network elements can broadcast control plane messages such as spanning tree and LLDP. If you want true 100% traffic, tap the blue Advanced Settings link and tap the checkbox. I can now select up to 10 different frame lengths. The number of frame lengths that I select impacts the duration of the test. A passing test with 10 frame lengths would take 10 times as long as a test with a single frame length. Frame lengths should match your MOP or standard operating procedures. I recommend including the shortest frame size, the standard Ethernet MTU, which is 1518 without a VLAN tag, 1522 with, and a jumbo frame if your network is provisioned for them. I recommend using the VIAVI enhanced zeroing in process to reduce troubleshooting time. It is a more efficient algorithm to determine the available bandwidth. I recommend using the default settings for the frame loss test. To verify a committed burst size that was specified in a service level agreement or standard operating procedure, set burst test type to committed burst size and enter the CBS in kilobytes. To determine the burst size that the service can support, enter burst hunt and range. A 2-second duration is adequate for CBS testing. Test durations for throughput, delay, jitter, and frame loss are specified in the next screen. I recommend at least 60-second duration for all of the tests. Unlike many RFC 2544 implementations, the One Advisor will measure throughput, delay, and jitter concurrently. These tests will complete in 1/3 the time of a standard RFC test. The overall test time for throughput, delay, and jitter tests will be the number of frame sizes times the number of trials times this duration equals 3 times 1 times 1 minute, or 3 minutes. The frame loss test duration will be the number of frame sizes times 2 times this duration equals 3 times 2 times 1 minute, or 6 minutes. You can also opt to configure a different duration for the frame loss test. Test thresholds should match your SLA or standard operating procedure. I'm going to enter values typical for cell backhaul. That's it for the configuration dialog. I can now optionally save these settings into a profile for future use. I am now ready to run tests. J Quick Check is a pretest. It will verify local connectivity, identify the loop type, and measure throughput prior to running the full-blown RFC test. It can also discover active VLANs and determine the maximum frame size, or MTU, for the service. It will quickly identify common issues, and you can go straight to troubleshooting the issues instead of wasting time running a long test. If you need to check the test configuration, the Go To button lets you quickly navigate to different configuration screens. The Results button lets you view the underlying Layer 2 traffic test configurations where you can view detailed real-time results while making real-time configuration changes to characterize any service issues. The camera button will store a screenshot on the OneAdvisor hard drive. The next button advances us to the RFC 2544 test screen, where I will run the test. As I estimated, the test will take about 10 minutes to complete. In the meantime, I can view test progress in the message log, or by tapping the magnifying glass. When the test is complete, green check marks and red X's indicate whether the test passed or failed. Note that the frame loss check mark is blue. The frame loss test is not a pass-fail test in RFC 2544. You can view the frame loss rate and frames lost to assess service acceptance. The last phase of the workflow is report creation. I can enter header information including customer name, tech ID, test location, work order number, and comments. I can also import a logo. I can create a report in a variety of formats including PDF. The concise report is typically 5 to 6 pages in length, including overall test results, instrument information, and test results, both tabular and graphical. That concludes the workflow.